Welcome to The Digital Couch, a podcast about the ever-changing world of digital. The Digital Couch is brought to you by Value First. The podcast features leading global thinkers and their stories from the world of business, management, and marketing. Now here's your host, Shauri Gupta.
Hello everyone. Today we have with us someone from Value First. Vijayan Dhaka is Senior Vice President and heads our automation and email business. I'm personally very excited to have him for this episode. Vijayan has been an industry stalwart for the last 14 years, spending his last decade in leadership roles at Cheetah Digital and Octane. He scaled up numerous businesses in marketing technology space. Vijayan, why don't you say hi to our listeners?
Hi everyone. Hello, Shauri, and thank you for inviting me to this.
My pleasure. Thank you for being here. All right, so let's get into this podcast. I'd actually like to start with the most typical question of 2020 out there to just get it out of our ways. How has COVID-19 impacted you personally and professionally? How has it changed your life? Do you also have a new normal for you?
Well, for all of us, we have a new normal, and I hope for most of us, it's a good normal because that's how it's been for me. And it's been a mixed last 4 months. So, yeah. Haven't met a fourth person in last 120 days. So you can imagine this is definitely something new. It's never happened with me before because. Been always with people around in office, outside office, friends, family, and traveling and going out. So yeah, a lot of things have changed. But the best that we could do to ourselves is only think positive about it and not let this feel down in any way. Of course, there are days when you do feel different and you feel a bit low as well, not the best of the energy and or the excitement because of multiple things going around. But yes, that's one can't do anything about it. We can't, we haven't, this is not our choice. This we can't control it. So we better live with it, accept it, and only look at try to be positive and stay in touch with friends and families the people you are living with in your homes. Try to engage with everyone, with office colleagues, make everything look. Yeah, it should be fun and excitement for everyone while we all are struggling with something or the other in our personal lives and at our homes. So what I do is try to keep myself busy, sharing the workload at home, trying my best to be a good help, also taking the lead on a few things, house chores and kitchen and cooking. Definitely helps, tried and tested. The day I feel lazy, that's not one of the exciting days for sure. The more things I do at home, the busier I get, the better it is. And then apart from that, there is definitely, it's like just keep yourself busy with work and with house chores. That's what I would say. Yeah, professionally, or if you talk about other things, this has been a very different time last 4 months. A lot of self-realization. Have a lot of time for myself. Like, there are things that you can think of doing which you never did before.
Right.
Also letting go of a few things which don't much, they don't matter much and never realized. A lot of things like, things we used to do before this started. So many of things that we have not even felt the need of doing it. So, definitely You know, who doesn't miss meeting friends and families, going out, eating out, traveling for work, traveling for leisure? Yeah, I mean, there are times when you do that, but it's all right.
Nice.
Yeah.
There's an impact. This is a new way of living.
And you asked me professionally as well. So professionally, yeah. I would say the approach has definitely changed for good. And everyone is dealing with this. We are all going through it together. We are business partners, our clients, people who we are talking to, our prospects. Everyone is going through, as an individual, everyone is going through this. So they all we all can relate to each other and relate with each other. So, you know, more of virtual meetings, as you know, everyone is following that. Mm. But importantly, I would say that there is much more clarity of thought now that I experience in my conversations with other people. I mean, even at office, with our clients, business partners, everyone. Like, it's the conversations are crisp, to the point, very well thought of. People are more prepared than ever, and this is a great thing to do. So that's what I would say. This is the takeaway, biggest takeaway that I've experienced, not only with me, but with others as well. Yeah.
Fair enough, with you on all the points above. Now that the typical one questions out, I'd like to come to your story and the fact that you've seen this world of marketing or sales evolve firsthand. I mean, from the days of cold calling, now how marketing is more about community building. It's about a brand approach. Do you want to take us through this journey that you've had as an insider?
Yeah, I mean, it's been quite a journey, eventful journey for me, personally speaking. You know, I started my career with a call center in Gurgaon. And then I did a lot of cold calling later in my job at policybazaar.com when it had just started, and a lot of things that we all used to do together. So making those... trying to make those leads convert into a sale, and, you know, cold calling people trying to sell insurance. So yeah, definitely it's a complete change for me last 10, 12, 14 years. Yeah. There was a time when I used to hard sell to, you know, one-on-one calls, used to sell insurance to people. But now these conversations with the CMOs and digital marketing heads and the CEOs are more value based, content driven, and we talk about business impact, and more importantly, it's always about solving a problem for somebody, for multiple businesses in and across industries, banks, retailers, you know, F&B clients that we have, then e-commerce companies and fintech companies. Yeah, so now we talk about solving some business problem for them, and that's more definitely that's very exciting to do, because when you're trying to solve a problem, and if you actually succeed in doing that, you see the results, and this is a direct impact on somebody's business. So nothing more satisfying than that. So yeah, that's what I would say, Shori.
So more collaborative than things were before, back in the days. For sure.
Yeah, this is a partnership. Here you don't have to sell, you have to work together with another business to solve a problem for them, or help them change their way of doing things. It could be digital transformation, it could be setting up a new solution, it could be working on their entire customer engagement strategy, or it could be implementing new customer touch points, or you know, things like more enriching customer reach programs. So yeah, that's what it is.
Got it. So in fact, you touch on a great point, and from there to pick it up, I mean, companies across the world continue to see changes within their success metrics. I mean, there are these new platforms, new CRM tools, new channels every other day. However, with most calling out on lack of transparency, and, you know, the fact that most of them are seeing a decrease in engagement, what can say marketers, even a marketer like me, do to acquire maybe say rich consumer data, and what are these key metrics that I should be looking at, if not just the traditional clicks and number of views on something?
Very different for each business, but overall I can tell you from my personal experience of working with the customer engagement platforms and marketing companies in last 10 years that we definitely underestimate the importance of rich in India, like as compared to other some of the evolved markets and countries. Definitely have a long way to go. Feeling some difference already because of the current situation and last 3-4 months, that but historically speaking, more often the brands or the companies or businesses have given importance to the new acquisition, customer acquisition, or new data they acquire. Instead of, they highly underestimate or undervalue the existing data or customer profiles or customer information that they already have. Some industries have definitely, like, you know, loyalty programs and company like hospitality, and they definitely used to do a better job, but we have a long way to go. Now, matrix, it's very different for each business, but overall I would say that the marketers, especially the, I would say, digital marketing experts, they need to think beyond performance marketing, or they need to think beyond spending money on Google and Facebook only. What they already have is something that can be nurtured differently, and definitely they can expect more results out of it. I would say starting from when you acquire a new customer, that's where your journey with that particular customer or subscriber starts. You need to do certain things to be able to build that long lasting relationship, and you know, there are so many market research reports, and there are so many facts that we all know. We can Google it, that definitely customer engagement strategy helps you get more than what you already may get out of them as a business. So setting the expectation right, I feel, is very important of as a first part of any customer engagement journey. So when somebody buys from you for the first time, or subscribes, or becomes a user, or somehow you with their permission, if you get to acquire a lead or a customer or a contact point, I think it's very important, and it's our responsibility as a brand that we must give them a preview of what's coming up in future. What can they expect out of it?
Yeah.
Give them the value that they, why do they need to sign up, or why should they give their personal information to you? Often I've seen this, you know, you would have experienced yourself in the stores or at the malls when you go and buy something. You know, the sales rep usually asks you for your personal details like mobile number or email ID.
Yeah.
But I'm very sure even they don't know ultimately why are they doing it. They think they're doing it as a one-time data acquisition practice by offering certain discount or reward points.
Right.
But that's not, we all know that's not how it is, and that's not how it should be. So it mostly comes across as a way of getting one-time discount, that from the end users or customers' perspective.
Yeah.
But it's not that, and it never was. So which is why I say that we highly underestimate the importance of having personal details of a user or a consumer or a customer. Second would be, I would say, communication in the right way to the right people at the right time and in the right format. I mean, this is a simple statement, but it's very complex when it comes to doing it for a business or integrating the solution or setting up a platform. But definitely communication is the key. I mean, we must move beyond just running discount offers or sales newsletter every time or communication. So that brings me to the point that marketers definitely should be looking at multiple programs and track them separately. I mean, if you want to get into the matrix, then it's not about sending a blast of communication through email or SMS or app notification, like one single message to everyone. Of course, there are informative newsletters, alerts, or some guidelines or announcements or launch that you need to communicate as a brand to everyone. But we must do targeted campaigns through programs as well. So multiple programs that a brand can implement for a better engagement. This could be a welcome series, a thank you series. When somebody, you can run a lot of cross sell and upsell programs, and you can call them whatever, birthday series. But there are so many ways of keeping in touch with your customer and consumer that that you need to invest in to build that long lasting relationship. And that's how you build connections. Yeah. And these connections are definitely, you must be looking at building long-term connections. Connections where your users or your subscribers or your customers, they feel that you are being taken care of.
Yeah.
Need to nurture those relationships. You need to keep your audience excited about your communication, not the other way around. Like, they must be looking forward to it. That's how it should be. That's where you build relationship. This is just like, let's assume today's situation. We must go beyond it. It's our duty. I mean, everyone should be able to do that. We must build, in today's time, we must be able to communicate to our users where they feel like they are being cared for, or we need to keep them educated about things, what's going on around us. We need to keep them informed. This is the time for every brand to create that difference and build that relationship. This is the opportunity.
Especially the part about nurturing these connections or relationships with potential consumers. But if I were to talk specifically about some tools, a couple of them you in fact touched on in your answer about marketing automation and email, especially email, which has come a long way across the years. What is in store for these channels for the coming days, especially with what's happened recently?
Yeah, like I said just before this, this is definitely an opportunity for every brand or a marketer to build that equity, that long-term connection with their users. I mean, they need to be different and they need to be genuine. Like, authenticity in every communication can do wonders. Be genuine. If simple things like, there's a small brand that I ordered something from before COVID happened, and then I felt the need to return it or get it replaced. So without me reaching out to them, they were too proactive, and they sent me a communication saying that they will now have a no questions asked return or refund policy for next valid or applicable for next 3 months. And then they extended further basis the situation. So simple things like these, I mean, you feel good about it. Somebody, it can be a it felt like they care for it and for our relationship. So that's where and this is all is just possible when it can't be possible without technology. So you can't reach out to everyone personally. Nothing better than that. But yeah, I mean, technology has helped us enable things that do look like one-on-one communication. So, and this is where automation and digital marketing comes into picture. So, we have seen last 2-3 months, we have seen as a business, I would say, well, nobody could see this coming, but I can tell you that we were always prepared for a surge in the business owing to the ecosystem that we operate in, which is customer engagement through digital channels. And we could see this coming, so we were invested enough to handle or manage the scale of business. And I can tell you that last month the number of communications sent out through our platform, it increased by 70% month on month. Nice. Which the brands are reaching out to their users more than ever. And this is not just a month on month increase. Actually, for last 1 year, if I look at monthly average communication or customer reach, on average, we have seen the 70% surge in the number of messages sent out through our platform. So this is definitely a signal and an indication of future. Like, and the future is here. It's now. We are already seeing it every day. Brands reaching out to their users through digital channels more than ever, and in the right way as well. So a lot of demand on automation, or for automation platforms. We are extremely occupied as a team in not only handling the queries coming in from our existing clients plus new prospects as well, but also busy in implementing these automation tools for our clients.
Thanks, Vijayant. This indeed is also the fourth industrial revolution that's happening in our industry with what's happening digitally and how automation is working on it. I'd now like to turn the table slightly and want to speak more about, say, the consumer journey, which is the better half for all of us. So how does mapping the consumer journey play a role in the early trails of customer experience? And you've been a sales and a business leader, so what are your thoughts on this particular part?
Well, extremely important for every marketer to map the customer journey. I mean, the more you do that, the better experience you can create for your customers or your users. So what one should be able to do is definitely go just beyond the traffic onto the website or your online store or anywhere. Like, you know, you must go beyond that. So instead, focus on tracking behaviors and the preferences, and then see if there is a possibility of reading their buying pattern or their interests. Can we read signs? And then, you know, everything put together, try to build those insights which help us craft a communication accordingly, which is relevant, contextual, authentic, beautifully designed, so it looks nice on a mobile phone or your laptop. And then, yeah, try to make most out of your marketing investments. So things like these, and you know, there are for everything there is a technology, there is a platform, there is a science, and there is a team of talent pool out there. So many of so many companies like us who do this. This is the skill set that they have acquired over a period of time, and put those learnings back into the platform and the team. And I'm sure there are so many experts out there who can help us or help brands do this. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, while what you can as a marketer, you could still do is you automate as much as possible, because what happens then if you are able to automate most of your marketing communications or efforts, then you get more time to think and to plan. And you can invest that time in creating coming up with a strategy and right. Focus on implementing that strategy, which gives you the definite or the, I would say a better outcome or result every time you execute a plan, including things like your creatives, the entire overall design experience, the way you talk to your users, and being different and innovative. And again, like I said, genuine and authentic communications, they always work better than just running a sale-based or an offer-based or a discount-based customer communication or engagement programs. Like, I would say every brand should take a break from just trying to sell. I mean, that's the problem. We definitely must move from our focus from trying to sell every time we reach out to our customers. So instead of sending out a newsletter which only talks about 30% discount on something, I would say just reach out and say hi and ask them how they are feeling or how they are doing today. In today's time, showing that care or concern for our users can definitely help brands create a reputation of being a responsible brand. So maybe organizing a mental health workshop for your buyers or your users, or a meditation or a yoga class, some online learning course.
Yeah.
Or try to learn more about their hobbies. And then try to create a tailor-made experience for them, a customized communication. So there are brands who do it. So, but that's only a very few, So probably I would say an insurance company can focus on running workshops for their customers and the talking about the importance of buying a term plan or a critical illness plan or specialized health insurance plans that nobody is aware of.
Right.
And this is all interest-based activity. I mean, this is not about calling up somebody and pushing that plan, trying to sell something. This is the other way around here. You're talking about the users who have shown interest in going through this workshop or coming online and spending time with you. So that's how it should be, in my opinion.
Nice. With you on this, especially the last contextual examples that you gave. Thank you so much for that. Before I let you go, I have one quick rapid fire question for you, and you have to promise me that you can answer me without thinking it.
Okay.
One thing that about your
asking my net banking ID and password, everything else is okay.
No, I'll ask you that offline. But for now, one thing you love about your industry and one thing you don't love about the industry.
Okay, one thing that I don't love about the industry is I think it's painful to see that brands do not pay in time. Like, we run a business as well. We need to pay salaries. We need to invest back. So we are always ready for our partners. But I hope it was mutual.
All right.
That's one thing I don't like about the industry. What I love about it is the scale at which, the possibilities are limitless. Imagine that the impact that we create on our clients' business health. I think it's extremely, it's something to feel proud of. We're helping clients deliver the communications, the messages. At the time when their users needed them the most, you know, it could be a simple communication like an OTP over an email or an SMS. I mean, the speed at which we deliver it, it's the need. I mean, everyone knows that. I mean, we must be able to deliver an OTP in next 1 second to 5 seconds or 7 seconds, and we make it possible. So to imagine all these things, I think that gets that's a very different feeling, and it's a great feeling as well. So that's what I love. I mean, the impact. Yeah, we can edit this later. Okay.
Thank you so much, Vijayan. Thank you so much for your time and being on this podcast. I'm sure that our listeners had a great time understanding more about your journey, your tips on automation, email, and other things. Thank you.
Thank you, Shori. Love doing it. I think a great series and great initiative. I hope you edit it well.
All right.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks for joining us this time on The Digital Couch. Make sure to visit our website, vfirst.com, where you can subscribe to the show on the platform of your choice. While you're at it, if you found value in this show, do write to us at thedigitalcouch@vfirst.com. Be sure to tune in to our next episode. See you!